Let's say that we want to take 14 and divide it by 70. So clearly this is going to be a number less than 1. 14 is clearly less than 70, but let's try to do it. So immediately we say, okay, 70 goes into 1 zero times, so that's not going to work out. 70 goes into 14, well, it doesn't go into 14 any time, so we're going to have to add some decimal places. So let's do that. Let's add a decimal place right over here. Make sure we put the decimal right over there. But now we can think of it as 70 goes into 140 how many times? Well, 70 goes into 140 two times. Two times. And 2 times 70 is 140. And you subtract, and you are left with no remainder. So you're done. You can write that 14 divided by 70 is exactly equal to 0.2. Let's do a slightly more involved example like this. So let's say I wanted to divide, let's do a little more interesting. Let's divide it by 25 and see what we get. So initially we say, okay, 25 doesn't go into 1, it doesn't go into 16. We're going to have to add some decimals right over here. How many times does 25 go into 160? Make sure we put the decimal above it. So let's see, 25 times 4 is 100. 25 times 6 is 150, so that looks right. So it goes 6 times. 6 times 25 is 120 plus 30, which is 150. And now we can subtract. And 160 minus 150 is 10. And now we just bring down one more zero. We add one more place value. Notice we're not changing the value. 16 is the same thing as 16.0, which is the same thing as 16.00. So now you bring down this zero right over here. And how many times does 25 go into 100? Well, we know it goes exactly 4 times. 4 times 25 is 100. And we are done. We have nothing left to keep dividing with. So we can say that 16 divided by 25 is equal to 0.64.